More. In fact, everything.
Her hair is hollow gold. Her lips sweet surprise. Her hands are never cold. She's got Betty Davis eyes. She'll turn the music on you. You won't have to think twice. Pure as New York snow. She got Betty Davis eyes.
The quiet serenity of the setting belies the storm of controversy and interest the sculpture has generated. It sits nestled in a small pond in the backyard garden of 77-year-old art collector Robert Edwards, one of four figures in a composition entitled Wind and Spray. It has a history. In 1933, it was placed in the Boston Public Garden, but the nude figures evoked a howl of indignation, and it was hastily removed.
The nannies of the little children on Beacon Street thought it was knotted and wrote letters to the Herald and the Traveler, a transcript that was called in, and objecting to the figures, and was hastily removed.
Edwards was a personal friend of sculptor Anna Coleman Ladd, who created the piece. After her death in 1939, he acquired it and erected it in his garden. Davis has seen photos of it, says, yes, could be her, but so many years have gone by, she's just not sure. Edwards is amused by the controversy. But is it Betty Davis at age 16? What do you think?
She's close, yes, and she knows just what it takes to make.
Nature writes some of its loveliest poems in the process of what we might call destruction. In this case, no one was hurt. Here is the poem, courtesy of KHON Honolulu, and the past 4 days of the volcano Kilauea.
If you had to schedule a network, would you do it like this?
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Or this.
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Tuesday at 9.
Or this.
What should we play Sunday at 7?
Sunday at 7. Sunday at 7. What should we play on Sunday at 7?
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Tuesday at 9.
Or is this?
We have Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8.
Tuesday at 9.
Thursday at 8. Tuesday.
Commanding evacuations. The lava from Kilauea is not posing any danger to homes right now, but the volcano has been erupting all week. There are fears other volcanoes in the area may be getting ready to blow, and officials don't want anyone to get caught in a situation where they'd have to move out quickly. Again, their call tonight is for voluntary evacuations. There are no similar calls in the eastern Sierra tonight, although some scientists believe a volcano is brewing there. Small earthquakes continue to rattle the Mammoth Lakes area tonight. There have been thousands in the last 2 days, including two big ones. More on the story now from Roy Neal.
A swarm of earthquakes began with two powerful jolts that hit Mammoth Lakes last night. At the airport, a hangar collapsed, nearly destroying a twin-engine $350,000 airplane. But damage generally was light, although the earthquakes were felt in Fresno, 100 miles away, and at Yosemite National Park. The first tremors were followed by hundreds of smaller quakes. This is an area where there is volcanic activity. Geologists say it's too early to tell if the swarm of quakes might be leading to an eruption, or even if they were caused by volcanoes developing beneath the surface. Steam vents naturally from holes in the ground in this place. Now the earthquakes are dying down, their rate and strength slowly ebbing, but they have left behind a frightened group of people. There is still plenty of snow in the mountains that surround Mammoth Lake. Apparently, no avalanches were triggered by the earthquakes that swarmed there. And the landscape, at least for the moment, is quiet. Roy Neal and